So today we are going to start our first lecture on three-phase induction motor. So the figure from figure we can see the different parts of three-phase induction motor. So before we go into the further discussion of the different structure or different parts of induction motor, we should have a brief preliminary knowledge that why this induction motor are widely used in industrial application. Almost 90% of industrial drives nowadays use three-phase induction motors, which replaced DC drives almost completely nowadays in industrial application. So behind this replacement of DC drives, there are so many advantage. Has the first one is the induction motor is cheaper, it is robust in construction, it's efficient and it's reliable. On top of that, its maintenance cost is very less. It has a good speed regulation and high starting torque. And it also has a reasonable overload capacity. So these are the few reasons why three-phase induction motor widely replace DC drives into industrial application. So from here, we can see the different parts of induction motor. So here, basically, we have shown a squirrel cage induction motor. A induction motor basically has two parts. One is called the stator, which is the stationary part, and the another one is the rotor, which is the rotating part. Now, stator is basically built up of high grade alloy steel and laminated to reduce eddy current losses. And depending on the construction of rotor, the induction motor are classified into two categories. The first one is known as squirrel cage induction motor, as what we have shown in our this picture, and another one is called slip ring induction motor. Now, why squirrel cage induction motor are replaced by slip ring induction motor? The simple basic reason is that here we can see in the rotor, it is shorted with slip ring with external resistance. So by controlling the current through the external resistance, we can control the starting torque of this slip ring induction motor. Whereas in case of squirrel cage induction motor, we have seen that it is shorted with end rings. So there is no provision to vary the resistance or to vary the torque. Whereas in case of slip ring induction motor, it is very much possible by controlling this resistance to control the starting torque. Now, if we see the inside the deeper of this squirrel cage structure, so we can see here that the rotor bars are basically skewed in nature. So there are two advantages of this skewing. First one is that it will prevent the locking tendency of the rotor, and the second one is it is produced more uniform torque and less noise during operation.